Antibiotics were first discovered and deployed more than 75 years ago, but the development of new antibiotics largely stalled by the 1980s. In the last 30 years, a disturbing trend has emerged.
According to the World Health Organization, more than a quarter of healthcare-associated infections in long-term acute settings exhibit some form of antibiotic resistance.
This means that with antibiotic resistance on the rise, the antibiotics that we've relied on for almost a century are becoming less effective. One solution is to develop new antibiotics. Here at the Blainey Lab at the Broad Institute, we believe that an alternative solution is to combine antibiotics with existing drugs.
In particular, gram-negative bacteria like E. coli feature a thick outer membrane that keep antibiotics from getting in and effectively treating an infection. Recent studies have shown that combining antibiotics with other existing drugs can give those antibiotics a fighting chance.
One example is loperamide, a drug commonly used to treat diarrhea, but that has also shown an ability to disrupt gram-negative cell envelopes.
There are over 2,000 FDA-approved drugs used in hospitals and clinics today. And so to test every single pair of these drugs against just a single bacteria would take millions of tests and would require complex and expensive robotic equipment.
We wanted to make this easier, so we designed this microwell array device that effectively tests about 1,000 pairs of antibiotics and other drugs.
So what we do is we make these tiny droplets that each contain bacteria as well as a single antibiotic or a single drug. And then we load pairs of these droplets into each microwell. We color code each droplet to identify the specific antibiotic drug pair that got loaded into each microwell. And then we can use microscopy to actually track the growth of the bacteria within each microwell. And what we're looking for are instances where the bacteria couldn't grow. And in these cases, it might mean that we've discovered a synergy between the drug and the antibiotic.
For our first full-scale test, we screened 10 antibiotics against more than 4,000 compounds from the Broad Institute's Drug Repurposing Library. This library is a collection of compounds that are in development or clinical use for other diseases. After just 10 days of testing against E. coli, we discovered more than 10 promising combinations for further study.
We think that with time, we'll be able to scale up this technology so that many labs can screen 10 times as many drug combinations at much lower costs than an industrial screening facility. And our lab and collaborators are working to adapt this technology to a wide range of disease areas in addition to infectious disease.